to introduce this group because I love these folks with all of my heart. And I thank God for them. Do you all appreciate that Lester and Will to work hard all year for this thing? Can we give them a hand? They deserve it. Amen. Do a wonderful job. All year long, they're organizing, planning, getting ready for this thing. I don't know about you, but I appreciate it. Made welcome today to the break stage. Stepping out on faith.
Being the first group of them, weren't you always the guinea pigs? So until you get everything lined out, but good to see you, Dan. Leon, where'd you go? I see him. Yeah, good to see you this morning. Good to be here this morning. Well, thank you, brother. The Lord does a good job. Brother Joe done a good job, didn't he?
Amen.
Give a big hand. Monday is usually the best day for me, I think, because it seems like people mind the Lord. But it's been good all weekend, so I'm not going to put a measurement on none of it. It's been good. It's all good. Amen. Being up here like this and just worshiping the Lord out in the open like this, there's just something about this place that is unbelievable. Park service is great. If you go out and you see any of the Rangers or anybody like that, tell them how much you appreciate them or anything, because they just give us liberty here. Have y'all had any problems with any of them or anything? They're just great. If you need anything, they'll do it. They've even got a golf cart now that they'll take some of our older folks if you need it. If you can't get up down the hill, they'll take you in and out. And I appreciate that for them.
I've always had a place to sleep, clothes to wear and food to eat. God has been so good to me. I thank you, Lord, for mom and dad, best friends on earth I ever had. God has been so good to me. All I
Brother Ron.
I've always had a place to sleep, close to where it moved to me. God has been so good to me, but if all I have He took away, then I still would have to say, God has been so good to me. God has been so good to me. Now I'm thankful for my family. The little church where I attend, and for all my Christian friends. God has been so good to me. The little church where I attend, God has been so good to me.
How many of y'all was here yesterday morning for Ronnie's message? Well, Ronnie, I don't know if he told that or not yesterday. After he left here, there was a guy that works in a lab, and he said that he's exactly right about everybody being anemic and the blood being anemic in churches, he said, because well, if you don't have enough iron in your body, that makes you anemic. He said, well, Jesus Christ, when they drove the nails through his hands, he had iron in his blood then. Amen. And those that aren't preaching the blood now, they don't have any iron in their churches anymore, no in their blood. So that's why they're weak and anemic, amen? And this next song talks about that. That soldier was me. In a dream I was there when they crucified Jesus. In my dream I saw His great agony. Well, I ran to the man that was piercing His body, and when I pulled Him away, that soldier was me.
Though only a dream,
I crucified Jesus.
Was my sins He bore
on Calvary's tree.
When He prayed alone in Gethsemane's garden.
Simon Peter was there, and his heart was so troubled, and many that Jesus had touched by the way, well, they beheld their Lord, their bleeding and dying, and in the dream I could see that soldier was me.
Though only a dream,
I crucified Jesus. Was my sins He bore on Calvary's tree. believe he prayed.
I believe he prayed
that night for me. I believe he prayed.
I believe he prayed
that night for me.
He prayed for me.
I've been sick all weekend. I've been trying to kind of hide it. I've been had a head cold going on and everything, but right there, she's the deliverer that gave it to me. And I thank her very much for that. But I thank God that, you know, I felt good. My head's felt bad, but I felt good in body and in spirit, you know. When I get up into the rooms, when it really just hits me, and I'm just, oh, you know. But I get a good night's sleep, and I get up the next morning, I just can't wait. Yes, amen. He's good to us, amen. All right, Chris is going to sing you one here. Did I introduce Chris the other day, you guys? This here is Mr. Chris Castle. We've known Chris for a long time, since he's just a young man. And he plays, you think he can play the dobro, you ought to see him play the steel guitar. He is absolutely tough on it. As a matter of fact, when we get done here today, he's got to leave. And he's going to get to go and play with one of his idols down in Catlettsburg with Ronnie Millsap. Play the steel with Ronnie Millsap. He's going to open for him. All right, yeah. So you think about that. Now, he gets to play all over the place and steel guitar and stuff like that. He's good on it. But make welcome Mr. Chris Castle, would you?
Thank you. I just want to say thanks to everybody. I made my first trip here to Knoxville. I made a lot of new friends. Tickle me to death. Everybody asked me to play with them. That means more to me than playing big shows. You're playing for a different reason.
Amen.
It means a lot more to play for God than just be playing country music.
Amen.
And this song here, it means a lot to me. It's really touched me since the first time I heard it back in Camp Eaton. It's just got a good message to it. Everybody, if you're a Christian, you need to listen to it. Because you need to be changing if you're a Christian. If you're not changing, something's wrong. You just keep praying. I've learned a lot of lessons the last 2 months. And every word this song says, just every word we all need to listen to being Christians. Because every one of us has a selfish want every day. And it's changed my life. But instead of praying, God, give me this, give me that, I say, God, have your way with me. And God, do what you want to do with my life. Let me be a life for you. And I'm telling you, it makes a difference. When you start praying a sincere prayer from your heart, just for him to have his way with you instead of worrying about what I want. I want this or that. No, I don't. I want you to have your way with me, God. And I'm telling you, it'll make a difference in every one of your lives. No matter how long you've been saved, I would say 5 years before I started to realize that, and it's been a different 2 months. That's going to be even better how many years you've blessed me.
Yeah,
listen to this song. Shining upon me, there's
no hiding. It's wonderful glow.
I don't want to hide.
Now family and children, my neighbors and all my friends, when I'm in Jesus, then all others will know. Lord, empty me of every selfish thing that would hinder my sweet walk with Thee. Now shine down upon me and fill me anew. In every way, Lord, let me be more like You. Now shine down.
So I wouldn't have to pay for it. He paid for my sins. Don't it just make you feel good to know who we're serving today? To be able just to praise Him and not have to worry about everything because He's done covered it. That song just means so much. I mean, just think about what it says and apply it to your life because it'll make the difference. I'm telling you, it will.
Well, I'm glad the Primal Quartet's not here this morning.
Yeah.
Because we're going to sing every one of their songs this morning, it seems like.
When we sing with the Primitive right. And the Jacksons, we don't have any songs to sing. Because that's just about all we're doing.
That just means that Reagan Riddle's a great songwriter, don't it? Yeah. Amen.
We got the news.
One thing
the time shall come to die. The treasures of this world won't mean a thing, but the joy of knowing Jesus will banish all my fears, for He took away their estate.
Song for what the cancer tribute that we've done and everything, it's called I Just Held On. And it talks about how that no matter what comes along, as long as we hold on, we'll make it through. And she's trying to chicken weenie out on us, and we ain't gonna let her. The rest of us up there is telling her to sing it. So her voice may crack, it may pop, where she's sick, that's what she's worried about. She worries about stuff like that. But as long as it comes from here, that's all that matters. Bible says make a joyful noise unto the Lord, amen. And if it's coming from your heart and it comes out your mouth, it's a joyful noise, amen, if you're singing praises unto Him. So she's got to get over that, don't she? Can I hear a big amen? There you go.
He's got to ride home with me, so.
No, I don't.
Oh, that's right, we're in separate cars. Well, he's got to live with me.
I have a plan, folks. I love it when a plan comes together. George is tuning his guitar, but it has to be in drop C. We'll do him one while he's getting tuned up.
Sing us some song. Many times in my childhood, we traveled so far. By nightfall, how weary I've grown. Father's arms would slip around me and gently he'd say, my child, we are going home.
Oh!
when I first heard this song, I was down in Florida, and my nephew said, "You're going to listen to this song," and I just fell in love with it. And we had the cancer thing yesterday, and those of you that have lost loved ones to cancer, you know that that is a hard struggle, and the last few weeks are so hard on not only the patient but the family having to watch them suffer. And you know, sometimes you wonder, how did you get through it? When my mom was dying, it was just so hard to watch her suffer. Now, I would have took her place if I could have, but there's not anything that you can do. But I just held on to God during that time, and that's what this song says. It says, "I just held on."
Just tell me.
song there makes me think of that poem, Footprints in the Sand.
Oh, that's right.
You know, the guy sees two footprints in the sand, and for a while he just sees one set, and he says, Lord, where was you at that time? He said, that's when I was carrying you through your times and troubles. Aren't you glad for that, folks? Listen, been through some rough battles. I know Brother Dan has and a lot of you folks here, but there's a lot of times I didn't think I'd get through it by myself. And I'm glad that he picked me up and carried me, Brother Herbie. I'm sure whenever Jordan was in that wreck, you and your wife were in that same situation, weren't you? I'm glad. He's graceful. His mercy and grace.
Boy, I'll be grateful. Amen. God's glad we called on him. I was thinking there this morning, a few months ago, I was wondering about the year. You know, we don't know what the next year holds. Well, there's one thing I've learned in my Christian life. You know, sometimes it seems like people develop this mentality today that you just pray for something, God take it away. Try to reshape the scripture to say, count it all joy when you fall down to temptation, because praying God will take it away. That's not what it said. Jesus said, in this world you will have tribulation. He said, be of good cheer, because I have overcome the world. There's one thing I've learned in my Christian life is this, is that troubles will come like waves on the sea. Brother, I'm glad I'm anchored in Jesus. It's been a good
job. Bless the Lord. Well, from that song to this song, I promised y'all I'd sing this. I'd sung it down at the Jackson family reunion and had several people request it, so I'm going to sing it this morning. It's a song about what are you talking about? And if you go to the movies sometimes and somebody's sitting behind you talking through the whole movie, you know, and you're missing parts of the movie and you're like, what did he say? You know, and you miss the important parts. And it's the same way at church. You know, when the preacher's preaching, we need to be hearing what we're... I see Brother Dave go point at him and Lester. They talk sometimes during church. But anyway, you know, sometimes we don't realize that we're talking. You know, I'll admit that I'm as guilty as the rest. That's what this song says. But anyway, we were in a church service. Don't apologize, just sing it.
She wrote the Tater song, and now she wrote this song. I told her, I said, she's doing Ronnie's job for him, doing all these minister preaching songs here.
Some people at my church got mad. Well, they didn't get mad. But some people at my church said, are you singing that to me? I said, Lord's dealing with me on Take Pride in Your Pew song, so so if you're one that leaves your pew messy, Lord's dealing with me on a song. But anyway, but it,
oh, the thermostat.
Ain't no way you'd never make Berber happy, no matter what you're doing.
Everybody's got a different one. They're trying anyway.
Where's she at?
But anyway, I think that we can laugh and have a good time and laugh at ourselves. You know, I wrote this song because I realized I was talking. But we were sitting up there in a church service and preacher preaching his heart out, and I looked back through there and people sitting there talking, and I was like, well, what are they talking about? God gave me this song. And so, hope it don't make anybody mad. I hope that it's a blessing. Have you seen my new curtains? Said the woman to her friend. They're blue and brown all the way to the ground with a white thread woven in. And they just match my bed. I can't wait for you to see. And after church is over, you have to come home with me. Then another voice from behind my pew said, I've changed the points and plugs. And I gave her a tune-up, and I checked the gas for drugs. Then the preacher said, that's the answer, if you want to find happiness. Not only did I miss the answer, I'm not sure what his question was. What are you talking about? It's more important than God's word. Is it a recipe, a remedy, a funny story that you've heard? God's word is so precious, close attention we should pay. We need to hear the message, let it help us along the way.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hey.
Now a lot of things have changed since I was just a kid. We never made a peep in church. We learned our lesson if we did. Now a baby's gonna cry and a toddler's gonna fuss, and the preacher can preach over them, but what about the rest of us? What are you talking about? It's more important than God's word. Is it a recipe, a remedy, a funny story that you've heard? God's word is so precious, close attention we should pay. We need to hear the message and let it help us along the way. Now I'll admit that I'm as guilty as the rest, but I have promised God this Sunday I'll do my best to keep my comments to myself and listen to the word. And after church is over, I'll spread the message that I heard. What are you talking about? It's more important than God's word. Is it a recipe, a remedy, a funny story that you've heard? God's word is so precious, close attention we should pay. Need to hear the message, let it help us along the way. Set up here, I'll tell you that the schedules that you have.